college produces women who are persons in their own rights. Uncommon women who, as individuals, have the personal dignity that comes with intelligence, competence, flexibility, maturity, and a sense of responsibility. This can happen without loss of gaiety, charm, or femininity. Through its long history, the college has graduated women who helped to make this a better, happier world. Whether their primary contributions were in the home or the wider community, in advocations or vocations, their role has been constructive. The college makes its continuing contribution to society in the form of graduates whose intellectual quality is high and whose responsibility to others is exceptional.
Holly, it's nice to see you!
You too, Samantha!
Holly! Katie! How long are you in town for?
I don't know. I'm here in a woman in law conference. Very grown up, huh? I am now the young spokesperson at all the obligatory boring occasions. How's Robert?
Oh, he's fine. He was just cast in a TV pilot. He plays the male ingenue, and he's worried because his hairline is receding.
Holly, I forgot to tell you, Rita is coming down from Vermont. She told Samantha she had a six-year itch to see us all again.
Muffy wrote me and said that Rita was so fat at her wedding that she couldn't even walk down the aisle. She had to be lowered to the altar by a crane. I don't believe it.
Women's things. I've been reading Doris Lessing, and I think when I get it together, I'm gonna have a great novel.
Rita, how are you getting it together doing nothing?
I'm getting into my head. Kate, I want to hear more about your law firm. I think we need more women lawyers and gynecologists. I won't go to mine anymore because it's a man. Besides, I heard he had a twin.
Oh, but Rita, you really should get a regular checkup.
Samantha, what's it like to be married to Robert?
We're very happy.
I had to train Timmy.
I was going to join a women's group, but I couldn't decide what to take. Macrame, bread bacon, or consciousness wrap.
I hate the women's movement. I sent an article to Ms. Magazine, and this Noelle Schwartz sent me back a personal note saying I was a heretic to the sisterhood.
That's all right, Holly. When we're 40, we're going to be incredible.
Rita, when we were graduating, you predicted by 30.
Well, at least in college, they appreciated us.
No, they didn't. You were miserable. You hated it.
Well, at least we appreciated us.
I wish I was back there.
That says something about the quality of your life.
Kate already is incredible.
I don't think I appreciated women then as much as I do now.
Kate, you just lacked imagination.
Now, Carter, for example, was incredibly bright.
Now, Carter, for example, was a catatonic.
Want to make an announcement?
What?
I'm going to make an announcement, like at Mount Holyoke. Now, let's all pretend we're at the dining room table.
Welcome all you girls to tea this year. I'm Mrs. Plum. I thought I'd read to you from Emily Dickinson, class of 1850. To those of you who already know this, please bear with me. Contrary to rumor, I didn't know Emily. She never accepted visitors.
Miss Lyon's seminary was a place of high excitement. The building had been completed for the school that was to do for young women, but Yale and Harvard were doing for young men. The 80 students who enrolled the first year had the vitality and dedication of pioneers.
Our house mother.
She has syphilis.
coffee.
Thank you, Mrs. Plum. Mrs. Plum is our favorite house mother.
And Earl Grey tea. I love Earl Grey.
Dear, would you care for some brandy?
No, thank you. So, Kate, would you like a ride to Cambridge this weekend?
No, I'm staying here to work.
Care for some honey, dear?
Well, if you ever need a ride to Cambridge, I go every weekend. I used to date Wharton.
But that was before I knew what I wanted.
Yes.
Lila, aren't you staying with us for tea?
No, I have more reading to do.
I'd like brandy and honey.
I'm a senior, head of freshman in North Simpson Hall, and a psychology major.
begin. Your napkin, Carter, is washed and pressed every Wednesday and Sunday in time for gracious. Now, your napkin box is right to the left as you enter the dining room. And, Carter, if you have any questions, or just want to talk about psychology, knock on my door. It has a Snoopy calendar on it. I got that as a present from Kenny at Harvard. I used to date Wharton, but that was before I knew what I wanted. Goodbye. Oh, and Carter, I would avoid Rita. I don't know what the D.A.R. was thinking of. Bye.
The real problem for many educated women is the difficulty they have in recognizing whether they have been a success. Women will be part-time mothers, part-time workers, part-time cooks, and part-time intellectuals. When scholars point out that even the best cooks have been men, the proper answer is, but what man has been not only the second best cook, but the third best parent, the seventh best typist, and the tenth best community leader? Just like the pot of honey that kept renewing itself, an educated woman's capacity for giving is not exhausted, but stimulated by demands.
I am so tired. Why doesn't someone just come and take me away from all of this? Did you ever notice how walking into Samantha's room is like walking into a clean sheet? She and Susie Friend celebrate Piglet's birthday. Katie says you're very bright. Did I tell you what happened in Chip Knowles' women's history class today? Do you know Chip Knowles? He always wears clothes from L.L. Bean. You can never find anything you want in those L.L. Bean catalogs.
So I just order a decoy duck every year. It makes me feel waspy.
Chip's wife, Libby, graduated first in her class from Vassar. Anyway, I took women's history because I thought it would be guck, and it wouldn't look as obvious on my record as marriage and a family. As it turns out, this class isn't half bad. We read all the basics, the feminine mystique, sexual politics, Mabel Dodge's diary. Chip Knowles says women's history is relevant. Do you think women will lose their relevancy in 5 years? Anyway, after 2 months of reading about suffragettes and courageous choices, French dish comes into class dressed in a tight turtleneck and skirt. And you know how for seminar breaks, everyone brings in graham crackers? Well, this chick brings in homemade papers.
And she stands in front of the class and she tells us that she has not prepared her report on Rosie the Riveter because you girls are wasting your time. You should do. Mais avec what you have down here. Then avec what you have up here.
And in less than 10 seconds, the class is giving her a standing ovation. Everyone is applauding. Except for Holly and Rita, who grabbed the petty force and ran out of the room in protest.
I didn't do anything. Felt so confused. I mean, this chick was an obvious imbecile. But I didn't think she was entirely wrong, either. I guess the truth is that men are very important to me.
Well, not more important than you and Holly and Samantha.
Well, not always, Pumpkin. Sometimes I know who I am when I feel attractive. Other times it makes me feel very shallow, like I'm not Rosie the Riveter. I suppose this isn't a very impressive sentiment. But I really would like to meet my prince. You princes. And I wouldn't give up being a person. I'd still remember all the art history dates. I just don't understand why suddenly I am supposed to know what I want to do. I'm not even worried about next year.
although the attitude of society to education for women has changed in the last century and a quarter, the intellectual curiosity, hard work, and the spirit of adventure are still characteristic of Mount Holyoke. Mary Lyon, sending her early students out across the plains and seas, as teachers and missionaries said, "Go where no one else will go. Do what no one else will do." Some of her 25,000 daughters have blazed new trails, like Frances Perkins, Secretary of Labor under President Roosevelt. Others found adventure near at hand. Emily Dickinson went home. Today, thousands of alumni and students are serving their families and their communities with generosity and imagination, leading lives that enrich those they touch, ready to meet the unknown with steadiness and gaiety.
Hi, Carter!
I have a message from your L. You see, every freshman has a junior sister and a secret senior elf to help them through.
That's right. It's your elf who's been leaving all the candy in your mail and napkin boxes.
And she'll fix you up on the weekend, and that's real neat, too. It's fun to see the girls at tea, milk and crackers, too.
And try and guess which one's for you.
Don't you love Mrs. Plum?
Fall teas are such fun when she brings apricot brandy. Mmm, really yum. But milk and crackers is neat, too. Every night, the kitchen help leaves out milk and crackers and peanut butter and sometimes fluff for you.
You should come sometime, Carter. It's a real study break for me for my thesis on Claude Levi Strauss.
Now, I'm just a messenger here, and I can't tell you who your elf is, but Saya thinks she's found you a male caller. See you later.
For our Carter, no one's smarter. Your elf is a surprise, so open your eyes. Kanga and Roo have a Yale blue for you. A terrific date, he can't wait. We'll double at the game, but I won't be to blame if he's a little odd or a bit of a scrod. Hair by Thursday must be washed for the trip, and it wouldn't hurt to give the split ends a snip. Tonight's the night, it must be done. I'm studying with Sasa and Jill in number one. Some Hershey kisses and best wishes. Bring a hot water bottle. See what milk and crackers. Lovin's, you're out. Gross me out.
To profit most fully from the undergraduate curriculum, a student should examine for herself not only the nature of her academic interest, but also her conception of the good life and the kind of community she would like to fashion.
She remembered the way Melissa Blaine, her perfect cameo face, had smiled up at Lance. "Yes," she said, "I'm sure you've had most of the desirable women in the city, but I don't want to be among them."
"Then, I think it's time I changed your mind," Lance said.
Suddenly, Lance's hand slid to the back of her gown. With one strong arm, he pinned her to his chest, and the try she made, he could not push him away. He deftly unfastened the buttons of her gown, as if he had long practice in performance with DraftKings.
"What are you doing? I'm not one of your strumpets!"
"Kate? You're busy."
"No. I was just reading The Genealogy of Morals."
"How was dinner?"
"Lila, I don't understand why you never come. Kate and Susie's friend has been asking for you."
"I came in to get the Nietzsche assignment."
"Lila, you don't think I'm a good person, do you?"
"Kate, you're very good."
"Then why don't you come in here just to visit instead of always asking for the assignment? Lila, we roomed together for 3 years, and now I never see you anymore." "You're angry about last year in Greece, aren't you?"
"That wasn't your fault."
"I felt badly for you when both Icky and Thomas fell in love with me." "Lila, sometimes I think I should apologize to you, and other times I don't know what it is exactly I should apologize for.
I've never done anything deliberately to hurt you.
I want us to stay friends.
I know.
What are you doing next year? I don't know what's going to happen to me if I don't get into law school.
Kate, you're not supposed to hear until April. This is only November.
Well, I am Phi Beta Kappa, but I'm worried about my law boards.
Oh, my pumpkin, don't worry. You'll be Phi Beta by June in time for graduation.
Just think, you could be Muffet or Samantha or, God forbid, Rita. What are they going to do with their lives? At least you and I aren't limited.
Did I tell you I applied to anthropology graduate school?
Why aren't you continuing in philosophy?
I really like anthropology. I want to visit small towns in Iraq.
Lila, things aren't going to be better for you in Iraq. You don't have to make yourself exotic. You're a smart, pretty girl. Besides, you can't leave your room in South Hadley. How are you going to get along in Iraq?
Just fine. Kate, what's the Nietzsche assignment? I've got more reading to do.
You always have more reading to do.
Are you going to Milk and Crackers? I'll see you later.
Did you know that Hallie used to pick up men at the Yale Green when she was a sophomore?
Maybe that's why she gets on so well with Rita. They've got so much in common.
Lila, that's nasty.
We all have hidden potential, Kate.
I'm going to ask Carter to join us for Milk and Crackers. I think she's very bright. It's been a long time since we've had somebody to talk to in this house. About 3 years.
I'm sorry, Len said after a moment. I suppose I shouldn't have done that.
But you were asking for it. You wanted it. And you enjoyed every second of it.
Am I saying that anatomy is destiny? No, it is not destiny. Providing a setting in which these subtle constraints may be overcome is particularly the mission of a college for women.
Where are you going to use this thing?
I don't know. I got it because it made me feel grown up. I could tell my friends stories.
Our entire society is male-oriented. Now I, on the other hand, want abandonment.
Rita, don't you want some attachment, some love?
Some what?
Wouldn't you want the basis of a relationship to be some sort of mutual understanding, or some kind of...
Kyla, you're so beautiful. You want it. This entire society is phallic. The New York Times, the buildings, roads, cities, government, history, religion, shopping malls. Everything I can name is male. It's very easy to feel alienated. No man will ever do for me what they'll do for you. Or Katie, or even Samantha. So I have to take advantage. In my case, it's a moral imperative. I've got to go now. I'm auditioning for Clark. He's directing a production of another part of the forest. Forest, trees, logs, pine cones, elves.
I think she's wrong about the shopping malls.
Do you know the first time I ever really understood about sex was from reading The Group? I remember when I was 12, taking it down from my parents' library shelf. It was quite titillating. And my parents were happy I showed an early interest in the Seven Sisters schools.
Lie? I called someone today in Minneapolis and hung up. I hung up twice.
Who was it?
A doctor I met with Muffet last summer. I thought I'd visit him over Christmas vacation. That's really why I bought thing here. He was very responsive on the phone. He said hello before I hung up.
Maybe you shouldn't see a friend of Muffet's.
Muffet doesn't know him either. We just met him once at a museum. Anyway, I could tell he liked me. He smiled a lot at my legs. I'm very attractive from the kneecap to the ankle.
Guess I'm gonna stay with my gentleman friend, Mr. Peterson, over vacation. Katie thinks he's boring.
Not boring. See, the reason why I didn't talk to Minneapolis is because I was afraid I'd start giggling and be self-effacing and my voice would screech. And then I'd start wishing I was Kate or Rita.
Holly, you can't keep wishing to be someone else. You'll be smothered.
Sometimes I want to clear off my desk and say, respect me. I'm a respectable grown-up. And other times I just want to jump into a paper bag and shake and bake myself to death.
Happy birdle, doodle, doodle, happy birdle, doodle, doodle, happy birdle, doodle, doodle, happy birdle, doodle, doodle, near.
boy was hitchhiking cross country. I printed it on the back of a Vermeer postcard from the Chicago Art Institute. It's the only time I've ever written without capital or punctuation. I also liked the Dave Clark Five a lot in ninth grade. I thought I could marry one of them because they're more accessible than the Beatles.
My best was Leonard Cohen. When I was in high school, I wanted to go down like Suzanne with the garbage and the seaweed. Then I heard he had a thing with Joni Mitchell. There's only so much wistfulness one can stomach.
Anyone want some corn nuts? My mom just sent them from Naperville. You can't get corn nuts east of the Mississippi.
You know what I think the ideal society would be? If all women had communal apartments. Not bored concrete socialist apartments. I mean in a state. And everyone worked so childcare was rotated. And the men came to visit on weekends and they were nice and bright and charming, all those things. But they left on Mondays. Katie, that's just what it's like here.
Well, except my plan doesn't get boring. The men who arrive are Arabian millionaires, poets, lumberjacks. Not corporate lawyers or MBAs.
Katie, you're a snot rag.
Kate just grew up in Holiday Magazine.
I couldn't live in a society like that. I guess I'm not as strong as you, Kate.
I want to be divorced and living with two children on Central Park West.
Holly, don't you want to fall in love? I mean, you don't have to get married, but it would be nice to have a passion.
Yes. Except if I fall in love, it'll be because I thought someone was better than me. And if I really thought someone was better than me, I'd give them everything, and I'd hate them for my living through them.
You don't really expect to live through someone else, do you?
Yes. I think I'd like to very much.
Oh, Holly, you're too diffuse. You need to concentrate your efforts.
You want to play a game?
Rita, too late in the night for tampon bobbing.
This is a nice game for nice girls. Now, let's each take a turn and say, if we could marry any one of us, who would it be?
I'm already pinned.
That doesn't count. You can only choose from our uncommon pool. Holly, stop editing under this sofa. I would choose Samantha, because she would make the best wife. And in a matrimonial situation, I can admire her the longest.
Oh, Rita, would you really marry me?
Samantha, you're the ideal woman.
Oh, Rita, now I feel really badly because I wouldn't have picked you, and it would have been nice if everything worked out. This is difficult because it would be interesting to live with Rita. But Kate probably has the best future.
Oh, how about Susie Friend?
Don't marry a girl like that. Too many committee meetings. She'd never be home. Holly, you're sweet and funny, but I couldn't support you. And besides, there was Buddy, a problem at the club. I guess I'd marry Muffet, because she could get on with the outside world, and Piglet wouldn't drive her crazy.
I guess I would feel most comfortable being married to Lila or Rita, because I'd never feel I'd have to impress them. But when you get right down to it, I'd want to marry Katie. I would consider living through your accomplishments, Katie. And besides, I'm sure if we got married, my parents would approve. And one of us would get our pictures in the Sunday Times.
How about you, Kate? Who would you marry?
I don't know. It's all right, Kate. You don't have to marry me, I understand. Maybe you have to settle your career first.
I guess I just never thought about marrying any of you.
Kate, for a smart woman, you have a stunted imagination.
Well, if I were to marry one of us, I would probably have to be the main income source. That's excluding the possibility of trust funds. So, if I were supporting someone, I guess I would want to marry Carter.
Carter! Help me out!
I'm sorry, that wasn't very nice. I'm sure you'll be very happy together.
Carter is very bright. And besides, if I'm going to be a boring lawyer, then I want to be married to
anyway. Carter would need me.
Callie, I would consider you because you're such a good person. Except that would make me feel a little chilly.
No. I think if we marry, we'll have to marry outside each other. Probably men.
I came in to tell you I've decided what I want. I want to put Wittgenstein on film.
That's not Carter. Know what? We just don't propose to each other. And Kate said she'd want to marry you.
Carter, Kate is really the fifth catch.
It was all hypothetical.
You know what? I think when we're 25, we're going to be amazing. Okay, I'll give us 5 years, promotional and career development. We're 30. We're going to be incredible. That's all right, Carter. You're younger, so you have 13 years.
Connect me with a Dr. Mark Silverstein.
Thank you.
Hi, is this Dr. Silverstein? Oh, this is his answering service? Hi. A message? Respect me? I'm a respectable grown-up. My name is Simone de Beauvoir. And I should be back in an hour.
Holly, dear, take your feet off the table.
I really don't know.
spring semester, my junior year, my father stopped attending father-daughter weekend. You see, that year, my birder classmate, Ada Grutter, and I had decided that it was too dangerous for young women to go on long bird-watching trips unprotected. So I wrote home and asked for money to buy a rifle. Gentlemen, please don't stop me if I go on too long. Anyway, my father was appalled. He felt that firearms did not provide an appropriate pastime for young women. And he feared I might be labeled eccentric. But I bought the rifle anyway! Ada and I set up a firing range on Upper Lake where we reenacted the Franco-Prussian War. For 2 years, my family sent me notes from home saying, please marry Hoyt Plum, and can't you teach bird watching at the high school? Finally, being a dutiful daughter, I did. Now, if you will follow your daughters to the date parlor, we can begin our dance. This way, Daddy. Could you put out that cigar, dear?
In the growth of tradition from the time of its founding by Mary Lyon to the present day, the college continues to believe that the acquisition of knowledge of itself is not enough. Indeed, employers of graduates of the college seem to be looking for a readiness to work hard at learning unfamiliar techniques.
Roughly, this package just came for you.
What is this? For my Muppet? I can't bluff it. An Easter bunny for my pixie honey?
Is that from Susie Friend?
Hell no! It's from her father. Look at sign. Lovins E. Cortland Kippy Friend. He was behind me in the bunny hop of the father-daughter weekend. Lila, do you think I should plan to marry Kippy Friend? It's 2 months before graduation, and I still don't know what I'll be doing next year. But I am prepared for life. I could fold my napkin with the best of them. Lila? You want this? I'll give it to Holly. She'll eat it.
I asked my father not to come up this year. Actually, my freshman year, he came to father-daughter weekend. He kept dancing with Kate and telling me how lucky I was to have such a good friend. Kate told him I was the prettiest and the brightest girl here. Ever since then, I make it a point to be busy doing research every father-daughter weekend. Oh, I can't wait to get out of here. I booked a flight to Iraq for the day after graduation.
Really, Lila? That's odd.
I won a fellowship.
Pink Pants is leaving right after graduation also. Lai, if he calls, would you tell him I went away for the weekend?
We had another fight yesterday.
What happened?
Nothing. He tells me he wants to work his way around the world on a freighter. I tried to appear like, sure, that's fine. Have a nice trip. Send a postcard. I don't understand why when Samantha meets someone, suddenly she's pinned. When I want someone, they tell me I'm being clutchy, putting too much pressure on them. I don't want any commitment. I like being alone.
Me too.
Lila, where do women meet men after college? Does Merrill Lynch have mixers with the Time Life staffers at the General Foods Media Department?
I don't know who I'll meet in Iraq.
Lila, why don't you come out with me tonight? We can go to a bar. Not sleazy, but not the kind of place where two nice girls would usually go. We'll sit alone, just you and I, and two Brandy Alexanders. We won't need any outside attention. We'll be two uncommon women. Mysterious, but proud.
All right, I like that.
I'll leave for Muppet in a cola, Muppet in a cola.
I'll get it for you, Muppet. No, it's gotta be old Pink Pants. Lie. Would you sign an overnight slip for me? See, Lai, I know myself. And as soon as that phone rings, I'm just fine.
liberal education opens out in many different directions. When intellectual experience is a real adventure, it leads toward the unfamiliar. Students of the college are expected to encounter a wide range of opportunities. That is to say, uncertainties. A maturing mind must have an ethical base, a set of values, and wonder at the unknown.
Today and told me they saw a 280-pound woman on River Griffin who had her lips white and lives on Fresca. They offered me a lip job as a graduation present.
Pass the fluff. This stuff is vile. I bet the kitchen helped to comb the desserts.
I have something to tell y'all! Getting married to Robert!
Samantha, no!
College fosters the ability to accept and even welcome the necessity of strenuous and sustained effort in any area of endeavor.
Hey, man!
What's this?
You got a doll, man? With two button eyes and a pink little rear end?
I could really get into this.
Sally got a name, man. Piglet.
Rita, cut it out.
Samantha, I was only joking.
We're 21 years old and I don't want a joke.
Why do you got the doll?
I like my doll. I've had it ever since my daddy won it when I was in sixth grade at the Naperville Fair.
Samantha, you don't like me.
I like you, Rita. We're just very different.
If I could be any one of us, first, I'd be me. That's me, without any embarrassment or neurosis. And since that's practically impossible, my second choice is I'd like to be you.
Oh, thanks, Rita.
I don't want to spend oodles of time with you. You're not a fascinating person. But I do want to be you. Very much. Samantha, you're the ideal woman.
Robert says I never really grew up into a woman. That I'm sort of a child woman. I've been reading a lot of books recently about women who are married to actors and artists and how they believe their husbands are geniuses and they are just a little talented. Well, that's what I am. Just a little talented at a lot of things. That's why I want to be with Robert. And all of you. I want to be with someone who makes a public statement. And anyway, if I'm going to devote my uncommon talents to relationships, then I might as well nurture those that are a bit difficult. Makes me feel a little special.
Samantha, you are special. We're all special.
Hey, Rita, when's your birthday? Because when we get out of here, we probably won't see each other very much. And I want to be sure and send you a birthday card. I like you.
It's March 28th. I'm an Aries. Aries women are daring and impulsive. But have terrible domineering blocks.
March 28th is the day of Rita's birthday. Hip hooray! She talks so tough of Aries blocks. But what's so neater about my Rita is
I know secretly she's very sweet. Pretty gross, man, huh?
Yeah, man, pretty gross.
The college maintains that along with knowledge, compassionate understanding is a central human activity.
Came in here because I just got into law school and I don't think I should go. I don't want my life to simply fall into place.
Carter, can I sit here for a while? I'm frightened.
No, that's okay. I'll just sit here and then I'll go back to work.
Carter, why have you typed now is the time for all good 25 times?
I am cramming for my typing test. I need 50 words per minute to get a good job when I get out of here.
College places at its center the content of human learning and the spirit of systematic, disinterested inquiry.
I envy their confidence. I envy their options.
Rita, what's the matter?
I can't sleep.
What's wrong, Rita?
Nothing. I keep having these recurrent let's make a deal dreams. And my future is always behind the curtain. But the audience is screaming at me. No, no, take the box, take the box. I haven't told anyone, but yesterday I went to New York on a job interview. It was one of those, I graduated from a seven-sister school and now I'm in publishing jobs.
Did you get the job?
I did very well at the interview. I told the interviewer I was an English composition major and I liked Virginia Woolf and Thackeray, but I really want to assist and edit Beauty Hints. I told her yes. I think it is so important for a woman to have a job, and I would continue to edit Beauty Hints, even with a husband and a family. The big thing at these interviews is to throw around your newfound female pride as if it were an untapped natural resource.
Did you get the job?
Holly, don't be so results-oriented. Anyway, at the end of the interview, she told me it was delightful. I told her it was delightful. We were both delightful. Then she walked me to the door and she said, tell me, dear, do you have any experience with Xerox machines? And I said, yes, and I also do Windows.
Rita, you didn't really do that, did you?
I did.
Holly, I can't go into one of those places. I don't know what I'm going to do, but it's not going to be that. I won't throw my imagination away. I refuse to live down to expectations. Just hold out till I'm 30. I'll be incredible.
Rita, I think you're already incredible.
Actually, I do have a new fantasy that helps me deal with my future. I pretend that I'm Picara in a picaresque novel. And this is only one episode in a satiric life. Hey, pumpkins, let's go down and hit the candy machine and see how much weight we can gain in a night.
All right, I should do one kinky thing before I graduate.
No, I have more work to do.
And when the candy machine is empty, I'm going to start writing my novel.
North Stimson Hall, fourth floor, under my raccoon coat.
I guess everything's all right here. I just like being under my coat. Last week, when I was riding on the bus back from Yale and covering myself with it, I thought I had finally made it into a Salinger story. Only I hated the bus, college, my boyfriend, and my parents. The only thing really nice was the coat. I take that back about my parents. Do you know what the expression good gadavin means? It means someone who davened or prayed right? Girls who good gadavined did well. They marry doctors and go to Bermuda for Memorial Day weekends. These girls are also doctors, but they only work part-time because of their three musically inclined children and weekly brownstone restorations. I think Mount Holyoke mothers have access to a Didwell list published annually in New York, Winnebago, and Beverly Hills, and distributed on high holy days and Episcopal bake sales. I'm afraid I'm on the waiting list. You were on the waiting list for Johns Hopkins? I have a good memory for indecision. My mother says doctors take advantage of you, unless you're thin, and then they want to marry you and place you among the good gadavin. She says girls who have their own apartments hang towels from the windows so the men on the street know when to come up. My friend Alice Harwich is becoming a doctor, and I've never seen her enter a strange building with towels in the windows. Of course, she's a radical lesbian. Sorry to have bothered you. Hey, maybe you'd like to visit here sometime? It's really pretty in the spring. We could see Emily Dickinson's house and buy donuts. I think about her a lot. And donuts, I think about them a lot too. No, I don't write poetry and I haven't read the bell jar. My friend Rita has. I don't know who Rita's basing her life on. Sometimes I think she'd like to be Katherine Hepburn, but Katie has the Katherine Hepburn market cornered, and we're all allowed only one dominant characteristic. I'm holding a lottery for mine. Yes, I guess I do giggle a lot, and I am too cynical. I had my sarcastic summer when I was 16, and somehow it exponentially progressed. Lila, she's my nice friend who's merging with Margaret Mead, says sarcasm is a defense. Well, I couldn't very well call you up and tell you to move me to Minneapolis and let's have babies, could I? Well, sorry to have bothered you. No, really, I'm fine. I find great comfort in Lay Lady Lay. One bad apple don't spoil the whole bunch, girl, in my raccoon coat. And I like my friends. I like them a lot. They're really exceptional. Uncommon women and all that drivel. Of course, they're not risky. I'm not frightened I'll ruin my relationship with them or anything. Sometimes I think I'm happiest walking with my best. Katie always says she's my best, shredding leaves and bubblegum along the way and talking. Often I think I want a date or relationship to be over with, so I can talk about it to Kate or Rita. I guess women are just not as scary as men, and therefore they don't count as much.
I didn't mean that. I guess they just always make me feel worthwhile. Thank you. I'm sure you're worthwhile too. If it's okay with you, I'm not gonna tell Muffet I called you.
Muffet's the girl who was with me in the museum?
Commencement brings a whole set of new opportunities, as varied as they are numerous. By the time a class has been out 10 years, more than 9/10 of its members are married. Many of them devote a number of years exclusively to bringing up a family. But immediately after commencement, nearly all Mount Holyoke graduates find jobs or continue studying. Today, all fields are open to women, and more than 50% continue in professional or graduate school. Any one of a variety of majors may lead to a position as Royal Fade or Eastern Senator, service volunteer in Venezuela, or assistant sales director of Reader's Digest.
Have always been a genuine pleasure. Thank you, and goodbye.
College for Women of Talent is more important today than at any time in the history of her education. Women still encounter overwhelming obstacles to achievement and recognition, despite gradual abolition of legal and political disabilities. Society has trained women from childhood to accept a limited set of options and restricted levels of aspirations.
Polite.
the new James Taylor album last week. I put it on at 5 a.m. and I thought this will be a comfort. It'll remind me of my friends that I can make a connection between the past and the present. All I heard was, Carly, I love you. Darling, I do. How did he turn out so well-adjusted? Suddenly everyone I talked to has gone to medical school or found inner peace through X. I was hoping at least James Taylor would hold out for something a bit more ambiguous.
You know, for the past 6 years, I've been afraid to see any of you, mostly because I haven't made any specific choices. My parents used to call me 3 times a week at 7 a.m. to ask me,
Are you thin? Are you married to a root canal man? Are you a root canal man?
And I used to hang up and wonder how much longer am I going to be in transition. I've missed the comfort and acceptance I felt with all of you.
I don't want to go back and have gracious living and tea anymore. But I still want to see all of you. We knew we were natural resources before anyone decided to tap us.
Let's have a toast.
All right, pumpkin. A toast. To Katie's law firm.
To Robert.
To Rita's novel.
To Wallace Stevens.
I'm glad we got together today, too. I've been feeling a little numb lately. And I know I wasn't like that in college. All those boring meetings. I sit there and I look at those wingtip feet. And I think of Rita, Samantha, and Holly and Muffet. I'm glad we got together today, too. I miss you.
And I've got to go. I'll get the check.
We can charge it to Robert.
No, I'll think of the tax deduction. Holly, what are you doing?
I keep a list of options. Just from today's lunch, there's law, insurance, Mary Leonard Wolf, have a baby, bird watching Bolivia, a myriad of openings.
I've got to go. Ken says, I dawdle. You all have my numbers.
Marketing director for Procter & Gamble.
Ada Grutter won the Nobel Prize. No, she didn't really.
Let's go to the movies.
I have my card, so let's go see Crowds and Whispers.
Hey, Holly, did you know Melissa Weeks became a Rockette?
Timmy says when he gets the stocks and when I get my head together, I'll have a little time to do some writing. If I just make it to 40, I'll be amazing. You too, Holly. When we make it to 40, we're going to be amazing. You too, Muffy and Samantha. When we're 45, we'll be pretty darn amazing.
Down there on the floor, and no one there on the floor. Keep me down again.
best time I just.